but I get a little nervous when it comes to the art of contouring. How do I contour my face so that I look natural and not supernatural? Well, be afraid no more, because Kristofer Buckle isn't just one of Hollywood's hottest makeup artists. He's the beauty go-to for Gwyneth, Mariah, Jennifer, and Madonna, and he's also one of the most respected contour experts in the business. Pull up a seat, take some notes, because he's here today to teach you how to contour your face effortlessly and flawlessly. Kristofer, how are you?
Hey, Tammy.
I'm so excited you're here.
Well, I'm glad to be here to teach you about this, because it's something that's really very overwhelming for a lot of people in concept. But basically, contour is the magic of makeup. It's like the plastic surgery of cosmetics.
I love this.
So basically, you taking a drab or matte shadow, and you're adding it carefully to the complexion to manipulate the shape of your face.
Now, okay, for me, I have this whole thing where I feel like I have a little bit more of a round face. Mm-hmm. So what would be the tricks to kind of slim my face down, give me that model look?
Well, you've got beautifully high cheekbones, and so you would like to probably magnify those. And a round face usually is a wider forehead, so you can contour shadows on the temples up here on your forehead. That'll pinch the forehead in, and then the cheekbones coming in, and that would add balance to the roundness that you're talking about. And I'm gonna show you how to do that.
Perfect.
So if you're just starting out, you can use a really soft brush and a matte taupe eyeshadow. You can use creams also, but I think they're a little bit more tricky.
Yeah, that sounds complicated. This is sounding good. This sounds doable.
The softer the brush, the more soft the application, the more diffused. So the stiffer the brush, the more makeup that's gonna go on. Ooh. So you might wanna start with softer brushes.
Okay.
So right under the cheekbone, in the hollow, and you can see I'm gonna hold a brush handle here. It's starting from the outer corner of the lip all the way up to the top of the ear. That's where you contour your cheekbone.
I'm loving this. I'm already learning so much from you.
Yeah, so you just carefully build it up. And you take your time with it, and you look in the mirror. Make sure that you're frontal light when you do this, mm-hmm. because if you have overhead lighting, like in your bathroom or wherever it is that you do your makeup, you're gonna end up putting too much on, because you're already creating shadows. But at the same time, that's a really good way to test where shadows would work on your face. You can put a light over your head and see where the natural shadows fall on your face, and you can magnify those with contouring.
That is such a great tip. Look at you. It's like you know what you're talking about or something.
I've been faking it for a long time.
You should think about making a career of this. I mean, just consider it.
Sometimes I pinch my brush. You see me go like this, and it just tightens up and shortens the bristles and makes them a little bit more stiff, so I get more makeup deposit. So this is coming along really nicely, but I'm used to using a stiffer brush because I usually, you know, I'm a little bit more adept in this. So let me just go for it and I'll show you the difference. Cheekbone complete.
Love it. Now, you know, just to take a second to talk about the brushes, you have a plethora of amazing tools here. Do you have any advice for when people are going out to shop and trying to figure out what they want to do? And, you know, brushes can be so costly.
Brushes can be a huge expense, and they are definitely an investment. A lot of people will tell you, well, if you take care of your brushes, they'll last forever. Mm-hmm. Most people don't take care of their brushes in a way that it would take for them to last forever. So I actually really love going to art stores, because look, these are art store brushes.
That's fantastic.
This was $12. This was $7. This was like $4. This is what I use for concealer. This is what I use to contour a nose. And this is what I use for highlights. Whenever I add shine to the top of a cheekbone or something like that, you could use this for blush. But you don't have to spend a lot of money.
What I think is so great too is makeup artists really are true artists, and you're able to paint and create a beautiful face. So it's a great tip to be able to go to an art store and get something that's a little bit more affordable, especially when you're in the early phases of trying to learn how to do this.
Definitely.
Get the right tools.
Also, you know, in art stores, nylon bristles work really well when you're working with wet cosmetics, like a concealer, foundation, cream eyeshadows, and liners. Those work really well with a nylon synthetic brush. When you're dealing with eyeshadows and powders and dry ingredients, then you want to use something that's maybe a natural hair brush. So there's goat hair, which are usually these white hairs. And then there is also sable. But just make sure that you're at the art store and you feel them, because then you'll know if they're good enough or soft enough to be on your complexion.
OK, at you. All these magical tips. I love it.
Let me just get your other side going so that you're symmetrical, because contouring is really about creating symmetry.
Mm-hmm.
So some people, you know, I'm going to explain some other methods and other areas that some people like to contour.
Okay.
You don't necessarily need it, but I'm going to just show you so that you guys can all see.
Look at you being so kind. It's like you don't need it, but we're going to do it.
Well,
we kind of need it.
We're greedy. We're greedy about beauty here, you know?
We can be. Let's do it.
And I'll show you my favorite thing, which I'm joking, really, but you see when I move and my arm goes? That's my favorite thing ever.
You know what? You're
so distracting.
Look at these muscles. Come on.
That's not muscles. That's flab.
No, it's muscles.
Okay, let me
Girls
see.
At home are like, ooh, he can come do my makeup anytime.
Hey.
Hey.
Let's look to camera. I want you to see. Good. Now, another thing, a lot of people are dissatisfied with their nose, okay? Now, we can't all afford rhinoplasty, but also, even a great nose can use some reinforcement when it comes to photography and for film. So you can contour the sides of your nose if you want to narrow your nose.
All right.
Because darkness recedes. Darkness makes things look less. Or you could shorten your nose by contouring underneath. Some people have a longer nose, maybe it curves down a little bit. You can lift it by just putting some darkness under the nose like that, and it shortens the nose.
Look at me getting a nose job.
You don't
need one.
This
is perfect. What is it? The one, is this on the $4 brush?
Exactly.
Much cheaper than surgery.
Exactly. So some people have a little bump in the middle of their nose. All of these things you can just carefully just reduce.
Now, when doing the contouring, what's a good rule of thumb to see, like, the appropriate amount of, like, shadowing that you're creating?
Well, it's more about the eye. You know, you have to go with your comfort level. And if you're being photographed, of course, it has to do with the lighting. Some people, also, a lot of Asian women, they have a low bridge to their nose.
Mm-hmm.
In this area, it's very low and shallow. So you can contour in this area and create a higher bridge to your nose.
Oh.
Visually.
Fantastic.
Now, whenever you talk about contouring, you have to talk about highlighting, because contouring and highlighting together are magic. Because highlighting magnifies contouring, and contouring, you know, magnifies the highlighting. So, I'm going to show you how to do that as well.
Look at you.
But first, I have to make your forehead happy, because you are complaining about having a round face.
I know, my forehead is very sad right now, so make it happy.
So sad.
This is my sad forehead.
Another thing, when you're contouring your nose, you want to make sure that you look straight in the mirror, frontal light, and you want to ignore the natural shape of your nose, and you really want to just go against the natural. Like, if you just, like, hold a brush and randomly go down the sides of your nose, you might be contouring and reinforcing a shape that you don't like.
Oh.
So if you do have, like, maybe a bump in this area of the nose, like on the bridge, where a lot of people have that, you have to paint against it. So you want to, like, cut it off.
Perfect.
A lot of times, women gain a little bit of weight here and there, so you can contour the jawline. And again, if somebody has a little bit of a fullness here, you don't want to go with the fullness, you want to cut straight across it. You want to, like, chop it off visually.
Yeah.
And also, sometimes you can go down here. Some people have a weak chin. You can contour.
My chin is very
you
strong.
You do not have a weak chin.
I don't have a weak chin.
But you can just scoop all the way down like this. Some women, as they get mature, sometimes have some issues right here.
Mm-hmm.
And you can just scoop under here. You want to bring it down the front of the neck a little bit, though.
Mm-hmm.
Just so it's seamless.
Look at my seamless neck, guys.
Let's do your forehead.
Uh-oh, my forehead's feeling neglected.
Okay. It's just right in here. Right, the center of your eyebrow, out to your temple.
Center of the eyebrow, out to the temple.
Mm-hmm.
Making mental notes.
Now, if you feel like your contouring maybe is a little bit harsh, or is it not blended very well, you can put it on, and then you can take, like, a beige loose powder, and then you can just, like, dust it over that. So
perfect.
It softens the edges. Contouring reduces everything. Highlighting maximizes. So now we've reduced the hollows of your cheekbones. So now on top of your cheekbone, I'm putting a shiny, paler color.
Mm.
Now that's going to reflect light. Whenever you contour, you want to use a matte shadow, because that matte will absorb light and really magnify the effect. Now when you're highlighting, you want to reflect light because that will bounce light out. It's like if a woman's wearing a sequin dress or a satin dress, it could add pounds.
Yeah.
Well, that's what we're doing. We're adding volume by highlighting and adding shine.
This is such a great tip too, because I know in the past when I've had failed attempts at contouring, I used a bronzer, but a lot of times the bronzers have a shimmer to it, so I didn't realize that I was actually working against what it was supposed to be doing.
Exactly. It's okay to use a bronze color, like a bronzy color, but make sure it's matte and like, that's why I think eyeshadows work really well. But also, you can use a shiny eyeshadow to highlight your face. You don't have to use a highlighting product, although there's lots of them out on the market and they're great.
Nice. And which one are we using today?
This Mally Renko. And, you know, she's got some great products and they're really easy to get. So, and she's also a nice lady, so I don't mind talking about her.
Hey.
Now, I'm gonna show you on the nose. You can take your finger.
Okay.
See?
Mm-hmm.
And if you wanna turn your nose up a little bit, you just keep the highlighter, the shiny highlighter, and you just put it right on the tip, the upper tip of the ball of your nose. And then you skip a little, leave a little bit of a matteness, and then continue up to the bridge of your nose.
Now you work with a lot of celebrities.
Mm-hmm.
Do any of your celebrities, your celebrity clients, there you go. Do any of your celebrity clients ever get accused of having plastic surgery?
It's happened many, many times actually. And you know, I'm friends and I work with Kelly Ripa a lot for all of her commercials and things like that. And she jokes about it and it's kind of funny. But no, these people have not had surgery. And if you do it well and you really master it, you can definitely get the same effect as surgery. Especially, you know, more mature faces, you can really lift the face a lot with contouring. You know, if you do the cheekbones and you do the jawline and you do a little bit on the nose, these are things that change as we get older as well. So if you, all together, like all the little steps add up to be a huge effect.
Well, I'm already feeling way better about myself. I'm feeling like I'm coming to life.
Well, there you are. Well, I mean, come on, you're really pretty. So, but also a weak chin, you can highlight the front of the chin. Now, if you have a long chin, you can shorten it by going like this with the contouring. So it's like, you know, you play around and you learn what works and what doesn't work for you. Of course, part of this would also be adding a little bit of color. And so you could also do blushes then, and then you would move into your eyes and lips and all of that. But the contouring is part of the complexion makeup.
Perfect.
Maybe I should do that, huh?
Yeah. So show me how to show me how to apply a little bit of color to this if I wanted to brighten up my face a little bit. You've already given me the shape that I've been looking for. But now let's give me a little more finished look.
Yeah, because otherwise you could be a little beigey, a little drab,
I'm a little beigey and drab,
a little surreal, as you were saying earlier. Okay, so if you want to add some color to this, then you can use a tinted powder with pigment and dust it over, or you could start adding a little bit of blush. Smile gently. Now, when I do blush, I like to simulate what happens in nature, unless I'm doing a highly stylized, artistic kind of a look.
Yeah, more of an editorial look.
If you look at your face naturally and you see where, when you get embarrassed, you naturally flush, that's where you should really try putting your blush.
I mean, this is how I naturally wake up every day,
guys. Of course. Yeah, me too. But I use a really big, soft brush because, again, this is made out of squirrel, and I know it might not be a little PC.
Squirrels.
But I appreciate it every day. And I can still pet it.
You can still pet the squirrel.
No, I know it's horrible, but it does work very, very well. And it's a very popular hair and fur to use in brushes because it's so soft and it goes on so diffused. It can be a little expensive. So if you do have a less soft brush, you can just use it really, really, just try to practice and really not putting a lot of pressure on the brush. And also when you use color on a big brush, especially blush, because it can get very muddy, put it on the makeup and then put it on your hand like this because it takes the pigment and it works it into the bristles because otherwise you're lifting the pigment and it's right on the surface of the brush and so it's going to drop a big blotch of color and then it's going to be really difficult to blend. So if you work it into the bristles of the brush and then just work it into the complexion, it goes on evenly
Perfect.
And much more diffused.